Hello everyone, we have already started chapter Indigo and we are going to continue with the same in this video as well. But before that, let us find out what we have completed till now. Let us quickly recapitulate. Students, we have seen that Rajkumar Shukla pesters Mahatma Gandhi to come and help Champaran sharecroppers, and whatever information he had, he conveyed it to Mahatma Gandhi, and for further information, Mahatma Gandhi took help of other lawyers and peasants. Let's move ahead now. Gandhi complied. The messenger drove Gandhi home, where he served him with an official notice to quit Champaran immediately. Gandhi signed a receipt for the notice and wrote on it that he would disobey the order. In consequence, Gandhi received a summons to appear in court the next day. All night, Gandhi remained awake. He telegraphed Rajendra Prasad to come from Bihar with influential friends. He sent instructions to the ashram. He wired a full report to the viceroy. Monday found the town of Motihari black with peasants. They did not know Gandhi's record in South Africa. They had merely heard that a Mahatma who wanted to help them was in trouble with the authorities. Their spontaneous demonstration in thousands around the courthouse was the beginning of their liberation from fear of the British. The officials felt powerless without Gandhi's cooperation. He helped them regulate the crowd. He was polite and friendly. He was giving them concrete proof that their might, hitherto dreaded and unquestioned, could be challenged by Indians. Students, in Champaran, Gandhiji was becoming famous day by day. He was visiting the house of peasants, poor peasants, and he was gaining his strength. And this was something which scared Britishers. Now, what did they do? They had sent a message to Gandhiji. They had sent a notice rather to Gandhiji to leave Champaran, but disregarding Tirhut British official commissioner's instructions, Gandhiji proceeded to Champaran's capital Motihari and started operating from a house there. People received him enthusiastically, but he was stopped from visiting a nearby village by the police. He was driven back and served with an official notice to quit Champaran. But this did not stop Mahatma Gandhi. When Gandhi was summoned to the court for flaunting the official order to quit Champaran, the peasants in thousands flocked the courtroom to support Gandhiji. The crowds became unmanageable, and this show of his strength and solidarity showed that Indians no longer dreaded the Britishers and they could challenge their authority. Britishers could not manage the crowd and they had taken the help of Mahatma Gandhi. This shows that they were helpless. Finally, Gandhiji also, he was very friendly and polite. He helped Britishers in managing the crowd. But this act showed that Indians work together and they can do any disastrous thing if they are discontented. Let's move ahead. The government was baffled. The prosecutor requested the judge to postpone the trial. Apparently, the authorities wished to consult their superiors. Gandhi protested against the delay. He read a statement pleading guilty. He was involved. He told the court, in a conflict of duties, on the other hand, not to set a bad example as a lawbreaker, on the other hand, to render the humanitarian and national service for which he had come. He disregarded the order to leave, not for want of respect or lawful authority, but in obedience to the higher law of our being, the voice of conscience. He asks the penalty due. The magistrate announced that he would pronounce sentence after a 2-hour and asked Gandhi to furnish bail for those 120 minutes. Gandhi refused. The judge released him without bail. When the court reconvened, the judge said he would deliver the judgment for several days. Meanwhile, he allowed Gandhi to remain at liberty. Students, Britishers were helpless because so many proofs and evidences were provided by Mahatma Gandhi, which showed Britishers had done injustice to sharecroppers, indigo planters. Now, they wanted to delay the trial, okay, because they wanted to get something by which they will punish Mahatma Gandhi and justice will be denied. But Gandhiji did not allow this to happen. He said, he protested the delay, and when they said that he is breaking the law, he said that it is not done in such manner, but it's done for humanity. Students, here Gandhiji explained that he had not flaunted the official orders with the intention of breaking the law, but in order to render humanitarian and national service by helping the peasants of Champaran. He did this with the intention of obeying the higher law of being, the voice of conscience. And not only that, Gandhiji was asked to pay some money so that he can get bail. But Gandhiji denied and he was set free without any bail. This was also triumph of Mahatma Gandhi. Let's move ahead. Rajendra Prasad, Brij Kishore Babu, Maulana Majrul Haq and several other prominent lawyers had arrived from Bihar. They conferred with Gandhi. What would they do if he was sentenced to prison? Gandhi asked. Why? The senior lawyer replied. They had come to advise and help him. If he went to jail, there would be nobody to advise and they would go home. What about the injustice to the sharecroppers? Gandhi demanded. The lawyers withdrew to consult. Rajendra Prasad has recorded the upshot of their consultations. They thought amongst themselves that Gandhi was totally a stranger and yet he was prepared to go to prison for the sake of the peasants. If they, on the other hand, being not only residents of the adjoining districts but also those who claimed to have served these peasants, should go home, it would be shameful desertion. Students, here we get to understand that Gandhiji was sizing up the lawyers. He wanted to check whether feeling of humanity had emerged in their heart about peasants or not, because they were the one who were the residents of Bihar, okay, and they had seen personally the problem of sharecroppers. Now, after fighting for a longer period, he wanted to know whether without Gandhiji, without he himself, they are going to fight the battle or not. But lawyers said that if Gandhiji will be jailed, then they are going to go back to their respective homes. This disappointed Gandhiji because he wanted to see some changes in these lawyers. The lawyers who took huge charge to fight against Britishers in favor of peasants. So here there was no change. Therefore, Gandhiji got disappointed. But later on, lawyers realized that Gandhiji, being an outsider, worked for Indian peasants, then they should also support him. Therefore, after a while, they consulted and they joined Gandhi. Let's see ahead. They accordingly went back to Gandhi and told him they were ready to follow him into jail. The battle of Champaran is won, he exclaimed. Then he took a piece of paper and divided the group into pairs and put down the order in which each pair was to court arrest. Students, here lawyers realized their follies and they said that they will go along with Gandhiji. They will also get imprisoned. So when the lawyers reconsidered their decision about their course of action in the event of Gandhiji's arrest and volunteered to court arrest for the cause of the sharecroppers. Now Gandhiji was very pleased and he exclaimed his satisfaction with these words of
the Battle of Champaran is won. Students, here we get to understand that the Battle of Champaran is not yet over. Indigo planters did not get justice yet, but the main purpose of Gandhiji's arrival has been successful, and that was to get rid of fear from Britishers. Now here, lawyers were ready for the court arrest. They wanted to get arrested in the court in favor of Gandhiji, along with Gandhiji. Therefore, he says that the Champaran battle is won. Okay, let's move ahead. Several days later, Gandhi received a written communication from the magistrate informing him that the lieutenant governor of the province had ordered the case to be dropped. Civil disobedience had triumphed, the first time in modern India. Gandhi and the lawyers now proceeded to conduct a far-flung inquiry into the grievances of the farmers. Depositions by then, 10,000 peasants were written down and notes made on other evidence. Documents were collected. The whole area throbbed with the activity of the investigators and the vehement protest of the landlords. Students, at last, Britishers had to give up because Gandhiji was ready with the proofs, evidences by which he can fight against this injustice. So after knowing that Gandhiji is not a domitable person, they were ready for the negotiation. Now, all the problems of sharecroppers were collected by Gandhiji and other helpers. Okay, and there was a meeting which was conducted. And this had happened first time in the history of India that Britishers bowed down in front of an Indian. In June, Gandhi was summoned to Sir Edward Gate, the lieutenant governor. Before he went, he met leading associates and again laid detailed plans for civil disobedience if he should not return. Gandhi had four protracted interviews with the lieutenant governor, who as a result appointed an official commission of inquiry into the indigo sharecropper situation. The commission consisted of landlords, government officials and Gandhiji as the sole representative of the peasants. Students, here we need to understand that Britishers were not in the mood to give back the money to the sharecroppers. Therefore, they wanted to communicate with Mahatma Gandhi. They wanted to negotiate with Mahatma Gandhi. And before that, inquiry was made. Okay, inquiry was made, interviews were taken so that they will pay, you know, very low amount to the Indians. But inquiry was done, commission was made, and inquiry was done. And finally, what will be the result, we will find out. Gandhi remained in Champaran for an initial uninterrupted period of 7 months and then again for several shorter visits. The visit undertaken casually on the entreaty of an unlettered presence in the expectation that it would last a few days occupied almost a year of Gandhi's life. Students, when Gandhiji interacted with Rajkumar Sukla and heard his problems, he thought that it is going to last for only few days. But when he came to Champaran and started working on the problems of indigo sharecroppers, he had to invest entire 1 year and still the problem was not solved. Let's move ahead. The official inquiry assembled a crushing mountain of evidence against the big planters, and when they saw this, they agreed in principle to make refunds to the peasants. But how much must we pay? They asked Gandhi. They thought he would demand repayment in full of the money which they had illegally and deceitfully extorted from the sharecroppers. He asked only 50%. Then he seemed adamant, writes Reverend J.Z. Hodge, a British missionary in Champaran who observed the entire episode at close range, thinking probably that he would not give way. The representative of the planters offered to refund to the extent of 25%, and to his amazement, Mr. Gandhi took him at his word, thus breaking the deadlock. Students, as we know that Gandhiji was a meticulous person, therefore right from the beginning he worked wholeheartedly. He jotted down each and every evidence that he got it, and he went home to home, door to door, in order to collect the evidences. Therefore, he had a huge pile of informations with which Britishers could not fight. Now, finally, both of them were on the table to talk regarding the compensation. Now, here, Britishers thought that he is going to ask for the 100% repayment. But Gandhiji asked for 50%. Now, here, one thing we need to remember that for Gandhiji, it was their self-respect which mattered a lot. He wanted Britishers' self-respect to come down, okay, and the same thing happened. Money was secondary thing according to Gandhiji. The settlement was adopted unanimously by the commission. Gandhi explained that the amount of the refund was less important than the fact that the landlords had been obliged to surrender part of the money and with it part of their prestige. Therefore, as far as the peasants were concerned, the planters had behaved as lords above the law. Students, this had happened very first time in history that Britishers were defeated by an Indian. However, they tried to diminish the courage of Gandhiji, they could not. And not only that, this incident showed that Indians were united and they were one. Because of solidarity, because of unity, Britishers had to shed their prestige and pride. Therefore, he says that the money that they received was secondary and the pride that they received after winning this battle was more prestigious. Now, the peasants saw that he had rights and defenders. He learned courage. Events justified Gandhi's position. Within a few years, the British planters abandoned their estates, which reverted to the peasants. Indigo sharecropping disappeared. Gandhi never contented himself with large political or economic solutions. He saw the cultural and social backwardness in the Champaran village and wanted to do something about it immediately. He appealed for teachers, Mahadev Desai and Narhari Parikh, two young men who had just joined Gandhi as disciples, and their wives volunteered for the work. Several more came from Bombay, Pune and other distant parts of the land. Devadas, Gandhi's youngest son, arrived from the ashram, and so did Mrs. Gandhi. Primary schools were opened in 6 villages. Kasturbai taught the ashram rules on personal cleanliness and community sanitation. Students, having won the peasants' battle against their English landlords, Gandhiji got busy with the cultural and social upliftment of the poor and backward villagers of Champaran. Because illiteracy, insanitation and ill health needed to be fought against. Therefore, Gandhiji stayed on in Champaran even after the sharecroppers' problem was solved. And remember one more thing, that Gandhiji, whose name is known till now, okay, for his political engagement, he did not limit his task to political affairs only. He wanted to give a secured life, clean and hygienic life to commoners of India. Now, while he was busy in his mission of upliftment, the poor and backward villages of Champaran, Gandhiji kept a long distant watch on ashram. And this was not a task which can be done in isolation or alone. Therefore, he required volunteers. Some he got nearby and some he had to call from his ashram. Therefore, his wife, his son and other people together, okay, in cooperation, tried to change the life of sharecroppers, Champaran people. Let's move ahead. Health conditions were miserable. Gandhi got a doctor to volunteer his services for 6 months. 3 medicines were available: castor oil, quinine and sulfur ointment. Anybody who showed a coated tongue was given a dose of castor oil. Anybody with malaria fever received quinine with plus castor oil. Anybody with skin eruptions received ointment plus castor oil. Gandhi noticed the filthy state of women's clothes. He asked Kasturbai to talk to them about it. One woman took Kasturbai into her hut and said, "Look, there is no box or cupboard here for clothes. The sari I am wearing is the only one I have." Students, here the writer wants to tell us that Gandhiji took care of health and hygiene. Anybody who had problem, they were given treatment accordingly. And this made the people of Champaran aware about cleanliness, sanitation and a healthy way of living. When Gandhiji saw the filthy, very dirty state of living of women, Kasturbai was made to talk to them, and the problem was found that it was because of poverty, they were not wearing clean clothes. During his long stay in Champaran, Gandhi kept a long-distance watch on the ashram. He sent regular instructions by mail and asked for financial accounts. Once he wrote to the residents that it was time to fill in the old latrine trenches and dig new ones, otherwise the old one would begin to smell bad. Students, this shows that what was the condition of Champaran people before the arrival of Gandhiji. They were already poor because of a system that was implemented by Britishers. Next, they did not know about the health and hygiene, about cleanliness, about leading a healthy life. So it was Gandhiji who had brought changes in that area. And even after he was away from Champaran, after completing his work, he kept a watch on these ashram which he had made through letters. Okay, let's move ahead. The Champaran episode was a turning point in Gandhi's life. "What I did," he explained, "was a very ordinary thing. I declared that the British could not order me about in my own country. But Champaran did not begin as an act of defiance. It grew out of an attempt to alleviate the distress of the large number of poor peasants." This was the typical Gandhi pattern. His politics were intertwined with the practical day-to-day problems of the millions. He had not a loyalty to abstractions. It was a loyalty to living human beings. In everything Gandhi did, moreover, he tried to mold a new free India who could stand on its own feet and thus make India free. Students, having resolved the compensation issue, Gandhiji focused his attention on the social and cultural backwardness. This point we have already discussed. Now, in response to his appeal for volunteers, people very enthusiastically engaged themselves, right? Like Mahadev Desai and Narhari Parikh, etc., along with his family members. Students, here we need to understand that the values that Gandhiji nurtured, we need to discuss in details. Otherwise, it will be injustice to the person who solved the problems of indigo planters. So here we get to see that he was so simple and friendly in nature that at the request of a poor peasant, he came to Champaran. Then, after completing a huge task of indigo planters, okay, he says that what I did, whatever I did was just an ordinary task. Okay, so this shows that how unpretentious he was. Then we get to see that his humanitarian aspect, even though he was mistaken for being untouchable, he did not feel bad regarding that. Rather, he wanted to change the scenario of entire place. And he united entire lawyers, not only lawyers, but peasants as well, who used to fight one by one with the Britishers. Now, when everybody fought against Britishers, they had to accept their defeat. So all these things happened because of Gandhiji. And not only that, Gandhiji made all these people self-reliant, because this was more important, because they depended upon somebody like Gandhiji to get rid of this problem. Now, they should not require a person like Gandhi. They should be self-reliant. They should be self-sufficient. So this was taught by Mahatma Gandhi to Champaran people. And on the other hand, we see Britishers who were imperialist and who were callous, who were oppressor and terrorizer, who tortured these hapless peasants to the extent. Let's move to the last paragraph. Early in the Champaran action, Charles Frere Andrews, the English pacifist who had become a devoted follower of the Mahatma Gandhi, came to bid Gandhi farewell before going on a tour of duty to the Fiji Islands. Gandhi's lawyer friends, though it would be a good idea for Andrew to stay in Champaran and help them, Andrew was willing if Gandhi agreed. But Gandhi was vehemently opposed. He said, "You think that in this unequal fight it would be helpful if we have an English on our side? This shows the weakness of our heart. The cause is just and you must rely upon ourselves to win the battle. You should not seek a prop in Mr. Andrews because he happens to be an Englishman." He had read our minds correctly, Rajendra Prasad comments, and we had no reply. Gandhi, in his way, taught us a lesson in self-reliance. Self-reliance, Indian independence, and help to sharecroppers were all bound together. Students, we get to see out here that after teaching the lesson of self-reliance, he did not want to take any help from anyone, even though some of the Britishers like Charles Frere Andrews, who were pacifist, wanted to be Gandhiji's side, but he denied, because if he will do that, then again he will go back to previous state. Therefore, he says that being an Indian, they should be well equipped for their country and they should not require any prop in the form of any Englishman. Students, by this we have completed the chapter Indigo in two parts, 1 and 2. If I have missed out any point, just let me know. I will surely explain it to you all. Till then, take care. Thank you.